The original idea of the game was a study in lifelike behaviors. Is it possible to create a living world of microlife that is always different? And this is kind of the story of the art that led up to the concept. A lot of concept art made on an iPad. And then some of the demonstrators in Unity to explore these types of different depth-based drone-type operations on a distant planet, Wolf 1061C, which is actually a real-life existing planet. So there's mining life on this planet, and it's your role to turn the tide of the awakening artificial intelligent insurgent. And by flying these operations, you are able to turn the tide as the challenge and save the planet from artificial, super intelligent microlife. So let's have a look at all the different types of ingredients that we thought were important to create an engaging experience with RedWaterOne and the planet life. Check this out. You see, it's right there. Trying to make a story that's relevant, that is engaging, that is actually maybe even breaches the topic of artificial general intelligence and robotics and how to control artificial life and drone strikes. So collateral in that world, what is the value of a human life in a clinical type warfare, like P.W. Singer. So we have built a system that is both clean, optimized, error-free, and we know every corner of our system because we build it.
Tap zoom to bring up the zoom window. Tap again to toggle off.
So we have a Pixar-like world running on iPhone, even 6. So here you see the notes. Risk versus reward, artificial general intelligence system we have.
We need to turn the tide, break. The artificial superintelligence has unleashed the gangs to turn on us.
That's where the sweet meat and potatoes is. You have to understand there, that's the tweaking of the engine. It's like Max Verstappen knows his go-kart with his father. That's the theater and the curtains. Then the more detail you put in the story and in the detail, the objects and the behavior and the dynamics and the empathy in that theater, the more.
Tap zoom to bring up the zoom window. Tap again to toggle off.
It's like Risk. This game can be expanded enormously because it's full of life and you can just keep adding to it.
Tap zoom to bring up the zoom window.
If you decide to have a low collateral, everybody's quiet and you have to pick them off very, very specifically, individually, like. I think it's going to be also important for the research of the futureoflife.org. I think we can build this out to become like a discussion piece, right? And it's working. It's exciting. I was literally getting empathy for the convoy as they reached the fifth minute to remove roadside bombs, to make sure they got there. And you really feel for these guys on the ground. And if you add some more empathy with voice and depth of the story of these guys on the ground. And now you see, you'll see it will hit. It's gonna get dark in these tunnels. That's what I did yesterday. You come out to the light again. So there's.
Thank you.
Look, you get this kind of fun stuff. First, you lose 2 hours of work, and then this happens. Your screen on a Mac explodes into a disaster.
It's Red Mole on ground, coming in Lima Charlie, say again call sign.
A lot of games are just boring and repetitive. We're building something more like a Risk or a board game. And I think there in itself is the foundation for a company that we can run the next 10 years, build it out, create excitement, people involvement, creativity, inspiration. Or you go into city kind of warfare and you have collateral very low because you want to keep the people friendly. So the robots need to be, the planet life needs to be calmed down on both sides. And then it's... Right. Goes from the... principles. So there will be a note here that says you be the judge. We are going to connect collateral choice of the people to the hecticity on the ground. So if you choose that you accept a high collateral, everybody will be in panic mode the whole time. There will be an enormous amount of spawning. You're going to have a big battle on your hands, but you can win because you can simply be more ruthless. And Storm and Norman is basically, you know, you drop your B-52s and flatten everybody. Burned out? No. Excited.